Alright, I just finished it's a retirement stipend allocation spreadsheet calculator. It's on the Google documents and accessible to anyone. It's pretty simple. It's running on the premise that you have two bank accounts. One is a primary bank account holding a savings, the main savings. And the second account is very, very little amount of money, very tiny amount. And that amount is pulled in each month. So each month there is amount that goes in there reoccurring for 12 months, for 12 months. And then after that 12-month time frame, it is resettled into another number. And so you end up with another number. That is lesser, it's lesser than the first number. So you start out with a higher number first each month. And then the second year, it is not such a high number. And the third year, subsequently, less and less. Because as you retire, less money is needed for you, for your particular day-to-day usage. Now, when I say stipend, initially, I'm meaning the amount of money that is used as an additional to your retirement normal. Like if you had already the Social Security style, this is an additional to your particular income. So it's a very small amount. And the point of it is the main account, the primary account, is not actually in your name any longer. It's not in the name of the person who's retiring. The only is the tiny stipend account. And so with this smaller account, we're not dealing with big taxation problems. We're not dealing with any of this any longer. It's just a little tiny account, and you're only receiving a very small amount of money. And so it is not even a taxable event. It's not even a taxable event, this type of an income, really. But I guess it can be, higher you go, it can be, sure. If you receive too much, but the point of it is to avoid the taxation. So that's the initial one of the main reasons. The another point is my gosh, the death issue on instance. It's already done. You don't have to deal with government taxation or death of the money that you have earned throughout your life. And you've already parted with it. You've already given the main exposure of your wealth away to your heirs, to your children there. Now, so when this has gone on, then because you've given this all away to the children, then you have this extra stipend account, this extra primary account. Okay, now this primary account is given as a respect from the children. It is given as a respect from the children also because you've divvied it out. Though you keep this one main primary account to give yourself a little extra through your retirement, because you may find I don't know, cost of increase of something might go up or whatever. So back to the explaining of the account. What the there's two sides. I went with the left side, and then there's the right side of it, and it's called on the calculator page. On the left hand side is it is set already. You type in how much you're gonna have in your main primary account. Well, I say yours, but it actually is one that needs to be held by your children in some way, so it's not in your name any longer. Because the whole point of it also is to release you from release the retired person from the taxation issues and all of this paperwork and all of this jargons and all. This is another thing. It's like your whole life is going to be all about taxes, and if you don't accept it, if you don't accept this methodology, then you're saying that you are taxes to the death. You know that is your way, and the point of it is to avoid being and dealing with that process your whole entire lifetime. So you can have 20, 30, 40 years free from taxation issues if you take this route. I know, lay it on the children. The children will have the taxes to deal with, but that is their deal, and that's the deal it goes. So, when I'm then now on figuring out, so the first the, on the left-hand side, on the left-hand side of the of this little cutesy little chart where spreadsheet thing. It has the exact numbers, and so each 12, you use like a bill pay. So you take from that primary account, you use like a bill pay. And so you're paying this little tiny stipend account, this little savings, incoming savings. You pay it like it's 500 or it's 300 each month. And it reoccurs for the 12 months. And then there's a new number that revolves on the second year. And so that particular year is a new fresh number. And so it's a, oh, I don't know how do you say that. It denominates, it lessens over time. So you start out with the larger amounts of money per month, and then it goes to the lesser amounts of money per month. So you can go this way, which is quite easy. It's quite easy and straightforward. Just the simple bill pay. However, it will not take into account any money that is staying there, like from savings. Like if you start to accrue a savings, like let's say you've received money in each month, but you haven't spent it all. If this retired person in their stipend account has not spent it all, then what are you going to do with it? It's going to start looking like a huge taxable event all of a sudden. So you, if you did not want this aggressive bling in your face, then that's the wrong way to go. You're going to have to somehow swoop it out back into the primary account. So that's what's going to happen. Or you have to spend it. You have to spend it. If you go back, there's the other side. I have put on the other side the same instance on the right-hand side, and it includes the exact amount, the end balance. So let's say you have 30,000 as your end balance, and at that point, not 30,000. That's not what I meant. Well, anyway, you have to put it back, don't you? You have to put it from the smaller stipend account, any leftover extra, and you have to put it back into the main primary account. And when that happens, then the more of the interest accrues on that account, the main primary account, and it does not accrue in the stipend account, which is probably zero interest anyway, because it is a free hold there. Yeah, so that's it. That's it. I don't know. Maybe I went at it the wrong way. But you have to maintain, you have to main it would be lovely to set up the reoccurring one all the way through for the 20 years. I don't know if there's a banking software out there that does that already. That would be for the left-hand side version. If you're going with the right-hand side version, you're ending up with each year, at the end of year, it has to be renegotiated. You have to clear it out pretty much to zero. Well, $10 or however many they have, you have you put there euros, and then after that point, you re-enter the monthly income to it, the each year monthly the year's monthly reoccurring number. So if it is goes from the 450, and then the next year is the 380, well then you change it to update it to the 380. But with the right-hand side, it does tell you simply if you have made a mistake, another mistake, but if the retiree has overdone it and not spent the money, and so what was it? It was going to be like the 380. Well, then maybe it's 410. So it's 410 each month. So there's 410 going out into that year. So you still get access to that savings that you put. That you did not spend, so from the previous year, and so that is included. So I believe I did this all correctly. I mean, and then there is a few charts there for the years, and then there's also the chart for the monthly. And if you're looking at each one, I went from the 5,000 all the way to the 25 million. And if that is your main primary account held, those are the main primary account held numbers. And then that goes through the 21 year time frame. So there you go. And I don't know. I don't know. I thought it was it. I think it's correct. I think I've made it correct. I'm now wondering a little bit there, a little bit. I know. I'm always in there. I can edit this thing on the Google and on an instant, which is kind of amazing. But no, I'm not touching the formulas anymore. I'm only talking. Those little types where I have to give like the information and instructions. Those things, but I think I'm pretty much done with it. I'm pretty happy with the layout of it. 1, 2, 3 pages like that. It's finished. Yeah, I don't know. I don't. What a drag! What a drag! I don't know. All of this. Yeah. So there it is. The Candy Money Way version or the other. I went with that version. Yeah. Meaning. You keep it in the savings. And any leftover you have even a higher amount in your little stipend account. But that is a dangerous one because it does possibly become a taxable monster to look at. So yeah, there you go. So I guess we talk about taxes and all of that again because I don't know, my little New World Government thing has just become a big disaster and I haven't written it out on Wikipedia or anything. I'll try to get that going again. I'll try to get that going again and figure out how the page put it out there on the pages. And yeah, I've I'm a little tired about this situation, but that there it goes. There's the dealing with the stipend account is the best way to not have this exposure to yourself. Financially, and yet you are set in a certainty of what it is. And there it goes. And then you can not have to worry about it any longer. Oh, you do need the person. You do need the person to maintain it. If you're going with this the Swoop version, you need to have a person once a year change it and as to take the money out. So there is that does have to handle. There still has to be the person that clears it, and then resets it to the new number. So it does have what you call that, a little babysitting to it. And then there's what else? What else? The other side of it. Well, I guess they're maintenance-wise also, periodically checking at it, but nothing else other than that. Nothing else other than that. They're not. It's only one account that it feeds the other. It's one account that feeds the other, and that's all it does. So, but use it as a bill pay. If you use that account as a bill pay, you're paying into. Always have to pay it. That would be the easiest setup.